Greetings to you all, and thanks to the organizers of the conference for accepting my contribution and for their effort in transforming this event into a live online conference. Considering the current crisis, I hope you, your families, and your loved ones are doing fine. My name is Lara Comis. I have been working in experimental archaeology since 1995. I did my master's at the University of Exeter in 2003, and I am an EXARC member since 2009. After several years in commercial archaeology, cultural mediation, and public outreach in archaeological and historical heritage, I returned to academia in 2017. I am currently a PhD student at UCD Dublin with a thesis on experimental archaeology and archaeological open-air museums. Today, I will briefly present some potential applications of my ongoing research, speaking about a taxonomy of ancient technology. As a tool for integrating analysis, monitoring, and furthering research, taxonomy literally means arrangement method. In biology, this term indicates a method used to name, organize, define, and classify taxa, or groups of individual specimens. Linnaeus was the pioneer of taxonomy. Later, the term started to include the evolution of living and extinct forms of life and their geographical distribution, becoming part of what is known today as systematics. Among the many definitions we can apply to taxonomy, the most relevant to this paper is the science of classification. So, does archaeology make use of taxonomy? Since this paper is going to be left online for a while, I would like to start with a few general considerations about archaeology. Archaeology is the study of the human past. The archaeological record is very complex. It consists of material remains, which represents only a small percentage of the material culture of the past. The main reason for this is the irreversible action of time. The people who produced that record ceased to live long time ago. Archaeology, in other words, is dealing with heavily fragmented and heavily modified material remains. Even if rudimentary classification was historically used to arrange archaeological artifacts, it was practiced at a time when excavations were nothing more than treasure hunting in connection with antiquarian collections. One of the major scientific assets of archaeology is stratigraphic excavation. Since excavation is a destructive action, this method implies detailed recording and sampling of the archaeological stratigraphy, which allows subsequent extensive analysis and interpretation. With the development of archaeological science and dating methods, experimental archaeology naturally followed, testing in practice some archaeological interpretations. The more experimental archaeology was practiced, the more we were able to engage in ancient technology demonstrations. So, how does all this relate to classification and taxonomy? Let's see a couple of examples. The first example deals with the archaeological record and the classification of pottery in particular. Sherds of pottery are one of the most useful finds in excavations. Classification is key here, based on morphology and comparative studies. Let's see how it can be applied on the field. The second example deals with lithic technology. This is an illustration from a study in which, as you can see, the stratigraphic data has been correlated with lithic artifacts, soil morphology, and other environmental indicators. I think it can give a clear view of the complexity of the archaeological record and the necessary horizontal correlation with environmental studies. But more importantly, this study could perform a comparison between Korea and Japan thanks to an archaeological database, left-hand side illustration, and used technological considerations to perform the analysis, as you can see on the right. In other words, the experimental approach redefined classifications based only on morphology and introduced a technological aspect in the classification of the archaeological record. Traditionally, artifacts were classified according to their morphology and type only. One of the main revolutions that experimental archaeologists bring into archaeology is the constructive critique of typological classifications through the discovery of the production processes of the artifacts themselves. Experimental archaeology, then, is opening the way to the intangible aspect which is missing in the archaeological record itself and gave birth to ancient technology activities. So, let us consider a systematic approach to taxonomy in archaeology. Three different data sets seem to be available. The essential one is the archaeological record, as it is, fragmented, chronologically and geohistorically connotated, fixed, something that can only be augmented by the retrieval of new archaeological records. This dataset is in contact with the following one only in crucial points, such as gaps in the archaeological record itself. The second is experimental archaeology data, in which the aim is to gain understanding about the archaeological record through dynamic replication and includes experimental data collection and analysis. And finally, we have the potential of ancient technology taxonomy as it is performed today, based on experimental data. If we build a systematic collection of information about ancient technology taxonomy, this can be used to refocus experimental research, which in turn can reassess the archaeological record. This interaction between classification, experiments, and taxonomy is interesting when compared to the current developments of other natural sciences. The three archaeological datasets are indeed distinct, but their interaction can be very useful. The archaeological record is the starting point for all the work done in experimental archaeology and in open-air archaeological museums, where most, but not all, of the ancient technology activities are performed. Experimental archaeology is a research tool used to fill the gaps in the knowledge of the archaeological record. Open archaeological museums are trying to communicate that knowledge to the public with all necessary compromises and arrangements. Could it be useful then to build a database on ancient technology activities and consequent taxonomy in open archaeological museums? Let's see if it is possible and how it can be done. During the qualitative analysis of the online survey launched to investigate best practices in experimental archaeology and archaeological open-air museums, I was able to put together an interesting conceptual map from the study of experimental archaeology and ancient technology activities. This was based on qualitative analysis of survey responses and was presented the first time in Trento at the EAC 11 last year. The emergent pattern for ancient technology was particularly interesting. It's important to stress that these observations are based exclusively on the emergent patterns in the survey responses, which described ancient technology activities, and are thus not based on pre-existing studies on the history of technology. In comparison to the conceptual map describing the observations on experimental archaeology, ancient technology seemed to be clearer and more structured because no gap in knowledge was addressed. Could this map be implemented to strategize the collecting of data from archaeological open-air museums and maybe used to build a database for the collection and the recording of data as a day-to-day activity? This is a first attempt to add in the hierarchical relationships in the conceptual map. As you can see at the base, the material sources have been divided among organic and inorganic materials, and then expanded according to the information provided by the respondents on the activities they perform, in red. In green, some objects or features that were used. What is missing here, though, are the existing interconnections between the different technologies, which is very difficult to represent in a two-dimensional drawing. As a matter of fact, respondents included in the open answers very detailed descriptions which allowed the analysis to detect both causal relationships and connections among different ancient technologies, including their development over time. Could it be useful to try and map this in 3D in order to visualize the interconnected system of ancient technology? This is a first attempt in mapping in 3D using a free online software called Thoughtspace. All the information you saw in the previous slide were transformed into this 3D model, which allows to show the interconnections. This tool is interesting as it is a collaborative platform and could be used to share and implement the structure of ancient technology taxonomy in the light of what is performed in open archaeological museums. In other words, it could be used across our network to develop a taxonomy of extant ancient technology. If this is successful, this could return interesting information for a relational database. And yet, there is one missing dimension here, i.e. time. This would be a necessary element to add in order to connect extant ancient technology taxonomy to the archaeological record. some solutions might come from the world of systematics, which are accurately mapping in 3D the evolution of life forms, as you can see in this example. I am actually struggling to find a suitable platform to visualize interconnected systems. So, if you have any suggestions, I would be really grateful to hear about them. In conclusion, this paper tried to underline the existence of three interconnected systems, which could be integrated in a systematic way using databases and online platforms for exchanging information. The archaeological record, the experimental archaeology data, and extant ancient technology taxonomy. Open-air archaeological museums could gather information about their own ancient technology demonstrations. A comparable process is underway in the life sciences and has opened new perspectives in the use of the citizen science tools, or, as I prefer to call them, participatory research tools. Information about ancient technology activities performed not only in open-air archaeological museums, but also by individuals or groups, or makers, as they call them in the citizen science, such as reenactors, could be collected too, in a collaborative way. All of our network could participate with no harm in sharing their information. The result could settle the basis for a relational database, which could be useful for experimental archaeology, and ultimately, to archaeology itself. Thank you very much for your attention.